At first glance, the PX7 S2s and PX8s look very similar, continuing BMW's trend of drawing inspiration from the gorgeous designs of high-end luxury sports cars. They even share the same software and electronics. So what does the PX8 have up its sleeve that makes it worth the step up? We'll dive into everything that makes the PX8s great and help you decide if these are the right headphones for you. We were excited to be the first to receive the PX8s, and we put them to test for this review. We'll cover some of the key features that these PX8s offer, and then I'll talk about how I put these headphones through their paces and what differences I heard between the PX8s and the PX7 S2s. Now, if you are considering investing in BMW headphones after watching this video, or any other audio or video gear for that matter, keep in mind, if you do buy from Audio Advice, you get free shipping, lifetime expert support, and a price guarantee. Now, we really appreciate all your support so we can continue bringing you more videos just like this one. Also, if there's something we didn't mention in this review, be sure to click the link in the description to read our full in-depth review of these PX8s. Like the PX7 S2, Bowers & Wilkins bundles a nice headphone case that will protect your investment while you're on the go. I really like how the deep central pouch magnetically shuts to stow away all your accessories. Now, inside that pouch, there's a very long 4-foot USB-C to 3.5mm headphone cable and another generous 4-foot USB-C charging cable. The headphones themselves have a modern, high-end style. However, instead of just cloth and aluminum for materials, the PX8s feature fine Napa leather detailing and die-cast aluminum construction, which really helps these headphones create a special feeling as you wear them. And they were not conservative in their use of premium materials either. The engineers covered almost the entire surface with soft Napa leather, which you'll find on the headband and on the exteriors of the ear cups too. They even went the extra mile to make the zipper tab on the PX8 case out of Napa leather. It's the little touches like that that put these headphones up into that luxury category. The PX8 is available in two colors, dark black and a light tan leather finish. Both color options feature the lightweight cast aluminum frame, available in either dark or light metal finishes. Now, unique to the PX8 is its shiny diamond cut edges that surround the matching Bowers & Wilkins logo on the exterior plates of the ear cups. The style and craftsmanship remind me of their P5 headphone design, and this distinctive contrast creates sort of a crisp pop of high-end sheen against the fine leather and single cast aluminum finishes. Now, from a user experience point of view, everything electronically about the design is the same as the PX7 S2. On the left ear cup is a multifunction button that you can customize to activate the noise canceling and ambient aware transparency modes, or you can set this button to automatically activate your phone's built-in voice assistant. Pretty cool. On the right ear cup, though, there's a toggle switch that powers the headphones on and off and activates the Bluetooth pairing modes. There's also an indicator LED that flashes or illuminates a solid white to let you know the status of the Bluetooth connection and the battery. Next, there's an easy-to-find ribbed button for controlling playback in between dedicated buttons for raising and lowering the volume. And all of these function exactly like the PX7 S2. Now, finally, there is a USB-C port for charging the headphones and an indicator LED that will glow amber to show you when it's time for a charge. You can also use that USB-C port to plug in USB-C to a 3.5mm jack if you want to listen to them wired. However, keep in mind, the headphones still do need to have a slight charge to them, and you won't be able to use the microphones on board while it's wired. The PX8 weighs slightly over 11 ounces, which is less than half an ounce heavier than the PX7 S2. Now, I wore the PX8s for hours, and I was pretty happy with how evenly distributed the pressure was around my head and ears. I actually never felt once that I needed to take them off while I was testing them. Now, in addition, both PX8 and PX7 feature the same pressure-relieving memory foam that covers plenty of the surface around the ears with thick, extra-soft padding in the ear cushions and headband. Now, when you look at the Bowers & Wilkins music app, you can turn on and off noise canceling, turn the ambient pass-through mode on, and control your music and make other adjustments to these headphones. This is the same app that also integrates with BMW's newer products, such as the BMW Panorama 3 soundbar and the Zeppelin. And I personally like the idea of having an all-in-one app where you can access all of your BMW products, and the BMW's engineers can actually enable software updates so you know that your investment will continually improve over time. The PX8 features an advanced hybrid ANC algorithm developed by Bowers & Wilkins that utilizes a new DSP hardware platform and algorithms to optimize the audio for better musicality and call quality performance. Six microphones work together to deliver the best results. Two measure the output of each drive unit, two listen to the ambient noise from the outside world, and two provide outstanding voice performance with enhanced noise suppression. I will, however, give a slight edge in the noise canceling department to the PX8s over the PX7 S2s, simply because I thought the Napa leather created a little bit tighter and more natural seal around my ears. I found the adaptive noise canceling to be very natural on both headphones, without being too overpowering, but still able to cancel out those sounds that I needed it to. The pass-through mode performed great on both as well, and I used this multiple times when I was walking my dogs, where I needed to be able to hear the surroundings in the cars around me while I was listening to music. I do have to say, the noise canceling mode and pass-through mode still did a fantastic job of delivering high quality audio sound, and I really, really thought they did a great job at keeping it super natural. The most significant upgrade is the new driver inside these PX8s. Instead of biocellulose diaphragms used in the PX7 S2s, the PX8 features a 40mm B&W driver with an ultra-low distortion carbon fiber diaphragm. Since carbon is exceptionally rigid, the diaphragm will remain stiff, even up in the higher range of frequencies. This means that the stiffer carbon cone diaphragms can respond to transient attacks in a more pistonic manner as instruments and other nuances hiding in your music reach up into the higher frequencies. The result is less distortion across a broader range of frequencies with substantial improvements in the resolution of details hiding in the top end extension, especially on music where a lot of instruments are all playing at once. Now compared to the PX7 S2, the improvements in accuracy and timing were immediately apparent when we started testing these PX8s. Additionally, a 20mm voice coil that B&W says is based on their Captain Former, the same voice coil former used in the PX7 S2 and their premium loudspeakers. Although the PX8's voice coil is 30% larger than the 15mm voice coil used in the PX7 S2. B&W explained, these are positioned alongside updated magnets or motor systems that reduce overall distortion in the PX8 for improvements in resolution and detail. The drive units are carefully positioned and angled inside the ear cups to better direct sound into your ear canals. To me, the result was superior imaging and focus when it came to listening to music. Now, a lot of noise-canceling headphones on the market today will sort of envelop you in sound. I thought the PX8s almost had a more live feeling where the sound was in front of me, the vocals were right there. It was like I was at a live concert. I thought it was really naturally well done. Now we see most people using the wireless capabilities of these as to plugged in. So getting music into your PX8 is achieved wirelessly over Bluetooth with support for AptX Adaptive for higher resolution audio transmission compared to standard Bluetooth. Now this promises class leading 24-bit 48 kilohertz Bluetooth transmission and low latency. They've also cut down on the total time to charge to 100% from 3 hours to just 2 hours of charge time. Now with active noise canceling, the PX8s will run for 30 hours on a single charge. And I actually tested that claim and found it to be pretty spot on. Every time I checked the battery life, I was surprised by how much was still left. And when you start talking 25 hours of active noise canceling, it opens up the door for these to become daily headphones you can use regularly for work, home, or anywhere in between. Plus, in terms of quick charging, Bowers & Wilkins gives you 7 hours of charge in just 15 minutes, which is fantastic. And the wear detection probably played a big part in that, because that feature, whenever I took them off, they automatically sensed it, powered them off for me. And the same thing happened with the music. The song paused automatically right when I popped them over my shoulders for just a few seconds. That's a really great feature to help you save a lot of battery life. So how do these headphones actually sound? I tested the PX8s in various scenarios, like riding in the car on a long road trip, walking around the neighborhood with my dogs, and hanging out in a busy park. Now, the PX7 S2s and PX8s can handle the same codecs, deliver the same frequency range, and both have angled drivers. However, when we found out that they were switching from biocellulose drivers to a carbon cone driver, we couldn't wait to put them to the test, and that's exactly what we did. I used the Bowers & Wilkins app and connected to my iPhone 14 via Bluetooth, And then I logged into my Kobo's account directly in the Bowers & Wilkins app. I love the app's layout and the way it allows you to access all of your music streaming services within one app. It also has all the EQ settings, devices to connect to, and environment controls all right on one single screen. A really nice touch. Now, the first track I tried was Vibin' Out by FKJ on their French Kiwi Juice album from 2017. With the right set of headphones, this track can easily take you into another world and let you kick back and really enjoy the music. The synth fills the entire soundstage immediately, and the vocals have incredible detail. I really enjoyed listening to this song with the PX8s. At about the 1:15 mark into the song, the drums come in and have some snappy snare hits between the thumps of the bass. And this is where I really noticed the difference between the two headphones. With the PX8s, these snare hits seemed quicker, more powerful, and effortless than the PX7 S2s. It's definitely something that you have to listen for to really notice, but if you're going for a more audiophile grade headphone, you'll really appreciate this subtle upgrade. The next track I dove into was Hideaway by Jacob Collier from his In My Room album in 2016. Now, if you know this song, you know it has some incredible bass that fills the entire soundscape. Now, I listened for how hard it would hit and how well controlled and precise those big bass hits were. At about 325, the tempo picks up and the bass guitar plays a great riff in the background of the rest of the instruments. And it was actually incredible just how well the PX8s retrieved the subtle details from his bass guitar and handled it with such finesse and precision. It makes this song just so much to listen to with its broad presentation of lower frequencies, especially when you have a lot of natural instruments playing all at once. Again, compared to the PX7 S2s, the PX8s still have a slight advantage, feeling a bit more resolute and precise in timing. Again, it's something that you have to listen for a little bit, and if you are at home with no other distractions, these little differences will show up a little bit easier for you than if you're out and about with distracting noises around you, even if you have that noise canceling turned on. The sonic gains you get with the PX8s over the PX7 S2s, well, some might say they're minor, but they're definitely there. Upgrading to the carbon comb driver is a huge advantage. And if you're looking for the best of the best, these are some of the best wireless headphones that we've ever tested. Not only do you get the slightly upgraded sound, but Bowers & Wilkins is also known for its beauty of their products. And they definitely know how to make aesthetically pleasing gear that just looks gorgeous. With the PX8s, you're really making a statement. These are finely crafted and steps above the over-ear headphones that you see everyone else wearing. The diamond cut logo, Napa leather, and elegant design will have you standing out in the crowd. So, are they worth it? To me, the price jump between the PX7 S2s and the PX8s is 100% justified if your budget allows. If you want the best possible sound along with upgraded luxury materials, the choice is clear. Go for the PX8s. However, the PX7 S2s are still an outstanding option at its price point, and we don't think anyone's gonna be disappointed in them. I see the PX7 S2s intended for a little bit more rugged on-the-go use, while the PX8s stand out in a crowd on the go, or can be used as luxury headphones to kick back in your office at home and hear all the fine details in your favorite tracks. Either way, you'll be really happy with any of the headphones from Bowers & Wilkins. I hope this review gave you some good insight into the PX8s and was helpful if you're deciding on purchasing some headphones. Your greatest way of supporting us in making more videos like these is to purchase from one of our award-winning showrooms or from our website at audioadvice.com. Be sure to leave us a comment below and let us know what you think of the new flagship PX8 headphones from B&W. We'd love to hear from you. And if you have any questions about the new PX8s or anything audio or video related, feel free to give us a call, chat with one of our experts at audioadvice.com, or just stop into one of our showrooms and we'd be happy to help you out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.